Now this is how a proper wall looks like. Look at this thing. I guess it's Neodyinamite and welcome back to the Wild Age. An early access version of the game, which is a game that reminds me a lot of Kingdom, which I really enjoyed. So last time we did Island 1, we had to survive for 10 days. Now we're gonna try to do an attempt on Island 2, where we have to hunt down 100 animals and see how that's exactly it's gonna go. So, without further ado, let's go. And yes, of course, ladies and gentlemen, we'll be playing on hard difficulty as always. So it's time to ride. It's time for the King of Kings to once again take command over the kingdom and build a campfire. There you go. Alrighty. Come there, peasants. Come. For I have a job for you. You have to make me proud. Come on, boys. Let's make you some balls. Just like that, and I also need to was the other facet. There he is. Come back here, man. There you go. Have fun. Take the coin. Equip the bow. And start hunting. Aye, aye, my lord. We didn't vote it for you, though. I do not care. I am the king of kings. A king among... What the heck is this thing? What the hell? Okay. This is weird. This is like a new construction thing over here. What is this thing? Stone shrine. Oh! Wall tier 3. Tower tier 3 and higher. Town center tier 4 and higher. Oh! The shrines! Of course! The same mechanic that is in Kingdoms. Which is basically... If you don't know, ladies and gentlemen. You have to... basically take control of a specific shrine in order to... Like unlock a next age. That will allow you to build more advanced structures. And basically... to help you survive through the nights of never-ending darkness. And speaking of never-ending darkness, where the heck is a chest? I need that chest in my life. Also, there's like a... Ah! I was like wondering, there's like a way to rotate the camera. There is! It's a little bit confusing, just saying, but okay. I think somehow we'll be able to manage. Alright! So that's one thing to done. Now I really need to find myself a chest to speed up the expansion of my kingdom, because what is a king without a kingdom? Well, still a king technically, just without a kingdom, right? Like, this is supposed to work this way, right? Assume? No? Maybe? Carry on then! I didn't construct the walls though. This is the same thing I do like back in Kingdoms. I technically don't build the walls on the very first night, so... Is that a good idea? The interesting thing about this game is that the archers for now, this in this version, this is an early access version by the way, thank you developers for providing the key. The archers swap positions automatically, like they just swap the positions accordingly, like where the enemy could like attack. Okay, I see somebody coming. Yeah, we have an income, boys.
Enemy spotted.
Prepare, archers.
Attack.
Fire. Uh-oh. Oh shit, not me.
Enemy down.
Okay, never mind. Just look, my god. Right, that's good. That's okay, I guess. Everything going according to plan. Yeah, we just kind of like, you know, had a little bit of a difficulty over here. Okay, eat the bosh. Eat it. Eat it, you stupid horse. Come on, eat it. Pressing the thing. Oh, there you go. Like, you have to actually order the horse to eat. The horse won't eat automatically, which is... It, which is kind of a hard thing to get used to, just saying. So let's actually ride to the other side of the wildlands and see do we have anything interesting here. We have a... Oh! There you go. I was looking for you guys. Would you like to join me? It's not like we have any other option. Okay, but still, I don't see... Ah! This thing. I was looking for you. There you go. Okay, so with this found, we should be able to fortify the castle without any problem. And we're gonna get, like, later on, more archers. Right! Right back to the keep! Prepare the walls, prepare the arrows, the swords, the spears. Man, courage is all the thing we need in order to survive through the nights. For we are servants of the King of Kings. Hey! I'm gonna get like a hammer. I'm gonna get like another hammer. There we go. Okay, send the trader to bring him more gold. Bye, man. Come back tomorrow, please. Thank you. Okay, we also need a wall over here. Right. That's also one of my problems. Right, for saying into the forest, just to look for like some additional chest with coins. There you go. Exactly the thing I need. So these coins will be used to upgrade the walls. Okay, we have more puzzles over here, so let's include those guys. And there's like one more chest somewhere over here. Come on. Come on, give me that chest. Give me a chest, give me a chest, give me a chest, give me a chest, give me a chest. I need one a chest. I was a good king this year. I really need a chest. I don't think this actually is like a possibility. Oh no. Nope, don't see a chest. Okay. Right. There's like a lot of space towards this general direction, so that's like a thing. Maybe I should somehow try to send my archers over here. I'm not exactly sure how does the tree system works, because if this game is has so many similarities to Kingdom, I'm guessing that if I'm gonna try to destroy a trees in a particular like, sector, zone, whatever, then there's like a chance that the peasant camp will disappear, and that's something I would really, really would love to avoid, because, you know, in the end, the biggest problems are like lack of the peasants, not exactly like lack of space or money, like the peasants become a problem. So yeah, that's like the thing I would like to actually try to avoid. But then again, my hunters are not hunting the way they're supposed to hunt. I mean, they're not hunting at all. I need to somehow force them to go deeper into the forest, but I'm not sure how the heck I'm supposed to do that thing though. Right, we need to clear up some of the forest, so I'm gonna hire like a lumberjack. Lumberjack? Yeah, I think that's the proper word. And I'm gonna hire that guy. Hold on a second, just waiting for the trader to drop me some money. There you go. Thank you, good sir. Have a coin and bring me back more coins. Right. So there's like a space to make a farm over here. Like literally over here, right? So I kinda like, I'm need our cash. So let's chop down those trees and see how it's gonna go. There we go, all of those trees need to disappear. I want to have like a very nice big ass spot over here to build myself like a proper farm. There we go, this thing has to disappear. Come on, chop down, okay, cannot chop down this tree, I don't know why. Maybe I have to chop down first the trees at the beginning. Hold on, can I make like a wall over here? Oh, there's a chest over here, I didn't notice it. Oh shit, oh well. Hold on a second, is there like a place to make a wall here? Yeah, there is, on the far side, over there. Okay, okay, that could actually like work. And we're gonna try to destroy the trees over here and see will the peasant camp get affected by that. Like, would the peasant camp actually like get removed as well?
It's all about the science, as the King of Kings needs to learn once again how to rule the people. And the people will tremble in fear, I guess?
I don't know. We're gonna see. Right, how's the chopping going, man? It's going good, sire. I'm working tirelessly.
Good. Now work faster, you peasant.
I like how this guy decided to go chopping down trees in the middle of the night, you know? That's something healthy I've heard. That's really healthy. Mm-hmm. Uh-huh. Okay, cannot make a farm here. Why? Ah, I need the higher tier of the town center, but I can build the farm here. So that's exactly the thing I wanted to achieve over here. So after that, we have to push the wall far north, get more archers.
Enemy spotted!
And then we're gonna see how it's gonna go. Uh-oh!
Attack!
Yeah, he got attacked, just as I thought. God damn it, you stupid idiot. Why the heck you decided to go in the middle of the night to chop down the tree?
Ugh. Stupid. I'm surrounded by idiots. In every single kingdom, I rule over. That's why you morons can't deal without me.
Ugh. Upgrade the camp to the next level, so you'll be able to get like sites, and I can begin to get more farmers. So the farmers actually gonna be now the backbone of my economy. Also, I didn't send the trader during the night time, so that's like a thing. I think that it would be safe to assume that having the stone walls by around day 10 should be like okay. Right? I mean, I should be able to survive for the first few nights. Like, the biggest problem, if I remember correctly, at the moment is this side, because the other side is dealing. Okay, this guy looks like improved orcish warrior, I guess. Hey, what? You guys cleared the other side already? Okay, if you say so, that's fine. Archers! Fire! Okay, well, that guy died quite fast. Okay, you drop your coins. Come on. Come on, drop your coins. Come on. Come on. And you have coins. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Okay, you don't have coins because I need to pay you coins so you can bring me more coins. You know, logic. Right, so let's see. I want to have farmers. I think there was like 3 farmers per farm. Yeah, something like that. So 3 farmers. So 1, 2, And why the hell this guy is standing next to the... No! You're a lumberjack, not a farmer.
I want to be a farmer, king, come on!
No!
Why? Why don't allow me to be a farmer?
Because!
But I was good this year, I'm a good subject, man, come on!
No!
I'm gonna pay you!
No!
I need you as a lumberjack, not as a farmer.
Okay, I guess. But I will remember this!
Yeah, screw you anyway, man.
And here comes the blood moon, a never-ending night.
Actually, we'll end next morning, but still, you get the idea. Come on, boys! Need more archers? More archers are needed? More archers are required? Right, let's just hope that the fortifications will stand. I hope. The farm is standing. I like when you build a farm, actually, you get like a little tiny bridge over here. You know, that makes this place look more civilized. Unlike the other part of the forest. And the kingdom. Uh-oh. Whoa, that wall is getting... Oh, shit. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. That ain't good. Oh, shit. Ah! Fight. Fight, morons. Fight for your lives. Oh, no. My... What the fuck? The shit is that. What just happened? What was that? What was that? Something happened, the game froze and I lost. What the shit? Well, those has been unfortunate turns of events, apparently. Alright, so we have to sort this thing in a little bit more fashionable way. So, how about we're gonna get some stone fortifications, boys? Okay, so how does this thing works? I just buy this thing and I get the stone fortifications, or do I have to, like, sacrifice something or somebody? I can sacrifice those idiots if you really want to game. I don't see a problem with that thing. I can't cut down those trees. Why? Come on. Allow me to cut them. There you go. Okay, keep down cutting. We really, really need this place cleared. And also, I'm gonna need the money. I'm gonna use the money that you get from chopping down the forest to improve the walls. That's exactly how it's gonna go. This guy is actually building something here. What the? What are you building? Oh, you're building the shrine itself? Okay, that's actually something new. I did not expect something like this is gonna happen. Keep this thing in mind next time, you know? That actually we have to send like a builder to build yourself like a shrine, whatever that thing is. Okay. Sounds reasonable. Right, I got a double of coins. Let's see how much I have to spend to upgrade the walls to stone walls. Only one? Interesting. But okay. Okay, not to self, building the stone fortifications actually takes a while. Holy. Okay. You better finish it with Quistker, man. The night is coming. He actually managed to finish the walls. Oh, that was close. Woo, those are nice walls, man. I actually feel like I'm at some type of
enemy
castle.
Spotted.
I actually feel safe for once. Okay. Right, I wish you good luck if you want to deal damage towards this magnificent keep. Hell yeah! A fortress worthy of the King of Kings himself. Oh. So if you're gonna like wonder exactly what I did differently this time, instead of like making a farm and expanding the wall to the north, I just decided to get the shrine and then immediately upgrade the walls. So that's exactly the thing that's happened. So I didn't waste money for the farmers. So in the end, I had like the same amount of cash. I just spend it a little bit better. Right. Day 6 of spring. Wait. That was supposed to be the blood moon? The blood moon barely touched the walls. The shit. Why I didn't do that thing at the beginning? Oh, well. Yeah. Okay. Well. Yeah. This is apparently how it's gonna go. Okay. We need to have farmers now, please. So let me get some farmers. And hopefully, I'm gonna get some cash. Where is the trader? I need more money. If I want to get farmers, I need money. No, sissy, where's the trader? There he is. Can you, like, walk even slower, man? Like, it's not like we are all in a hurry, you know? It's like not we all gonna die if we're not gonna speed up, actually. Yeah, working with idiots. Even the trader, who is technically not part of my kingdom, is an idiot. All of you morons. Idiots. Pathetic maggots. Oh, found the blood moon. The actual blood moon found me. Well, shit. Okay. Alright, I got this. Should not be that hard, right? Okay, note to self that the farmers returned for the night to the keep, so they are technically safe. But still, I want to expand the kingdom towards north because there's like this nice, cozy territory over there, and there's like another farming spot that I would really would like to have, actually, if you think about that. Alright, boys, time to test the walls! Here we go! Oh my god, that's a lot of them. Holy shit. Okay, I'm starting to have my doubts that this wall actually will hold up. Oh. Well, I don't know what to think about this. The wall is already yellow. And I still see too many enemies over here. Oh my god, the hard difficulty is actually hard. Would you look at that? I may actually fail this thing again. Okay, those guys managed to defend, alright, but the other wall is like getting... I've survived! My walls! My beautiful walls! Oh shit! My beautiful walls! And here I was thinking that I can actually build the eastern walls on day 10. Hell no, baby! This is not gonna work. I need more archers. The sad thing is that at the beginning the archers actually like provided with a little bit of money, but the like the more you go, the more days pass, then the gold income actually from the archers is minimal. Like I'm barely getting any cash from the archers right now. This like this is not the same amount I got in Kingdom, where I could keep my economy like up to day 20 or something like that, just by the archers alone. Unless I'm doing something wrong, that could also be like a possibility. But right now I am not making half of the money that I normally do. So what I'm gonna try to do is that I'm gonna try to push the wall again this time to the north and see how that's gonna go, okay? But first things first, I want to see how an attack after a blood moon looks like. Like, is it as vicious as the one during the blood moon, or is this like actually, you know, more forgiving? Because I kinda like hope for the first option. First option? Did I say the first option better option? I'm not sure. Hard difficulty is actually hard. I am really happy with the challenge, but I'm unhappy with how they smack my walls. A bit too much, if you ask me. Can I actually like upgrade the wall to the next level? I require a town center. Okay, and the hit points of the wall is gonna get increased by 100, so that's like a 1/3 of the current wall, actually, thing, whatever. Alright. Actually, half, not 1/3. 1/3 is gonna be after you upgrade the wall. So yeah, that's gonna be the thing. Right! I need coins! And this is how a proper wall looks like. Look at this thing! Tier 4, the maximum tier of the wall. Ho ho ho! Now this is what I call a proper fortifications, man! And also I'm gonna get this thing, because this is gonna add one more damage towards the archers. Town center tier 6. Hell yeah, what's this thing? Okay. 10 full villagers, 2 higher. Highest, here you can hire new villagers, but the cheaper way is to find villagers in the woods. Oh! Okay! That's actually quite nice, you know, instead of like having a bakery.
Go!
That works with me. Okay, archers should get into the positions very soon. I'm gonna get myself like more archers. Just in case, because I have a bunch of people. I got like a nice supply of gold. So now let's put this money to good use by providing me with the necessary fighting force. Just so you know, in the future the developers actually plan to add knights as well to the game, but currently they are like not a thing. But in the future, you'll be actually able to attack the enemy portals just to destroy them. So, for that, you need knights, and you can't get knights at the moment. Like, the knights will become a thing, like, as the game will develop in the later patches. Right! I still have to kill 35 animals to win this map. But so far, I would say it's going quite good, man! Oh, yes! All of the coins! Now, we can actually make myself a new farm over here. And that's gonna give me even more money.
That's exactly the thing I want to achieve over here. Glorious kingdom of the king of kings.
Right. The blood moon of day 11. Oh my god, that's a lot of people. Okay, one down. Come on. Oh, this is not enough archers. Oh, okay. It's actually more terrifying than I thought, you know? It's way more terrifying than I thought. I need to get more archers, man. I honestly need more archers. I thought that was gonna be enough. Nope. Nope. That's not even close the amount I need to have over there. Oh, the wall is gonna fall very soon. Uh-oh. The wall is falling! The wall is falling! No! Uh-oh. Uh-oh. Ah! Shit! I'm keeping my distance. I don't want to lose again, you know? All of a sudden, the pressure stopped? What the fuck? Okay, that's surprising. What the hell is happening over here? Oh, shit! Here we go! Ah! Oh! Hey, I lost my archer. Okay, that was actually quite scary. The fuck? Too bad that the archers actually don't stand on the fortifications, no? That'd be cool. Like, actually having like archers on those towers over here and around and on the walls itself, on above the gate. That'd be something cool. Because they're standing behind the gate like a bunch of lunatics. God damn it, man. So basically, we are progressing slowly and steady. I've made the fortifications like a boss. Those fortifications are like the best. Alright, so now we just have to count down 20 more animals and the mission will be done. Like, this is quite interesting that you actually get like different objectives. Even though that in the end, the developers will allow you to destroy the portals. So I'm guessing that like destroying the portals would also be like a thing to win the game. I don't know. But, you know, I'm doing exactly are curious how the end game will look like in the full version, because just keep in mind that this is still like work in the progress, right? This is not the final product. So things you can see on the screen can change a little tiny bit one way or another. So just be aware of that thing. But still, like, if you enjoy the game, remember to check out the Steam page and description below. And well, if you really like it, add the game to your wishlist, because I think that this game honestly has like great potential. I am loving every single bit of it so far. And now that I have an actual like castle, then I'm even more happy with this, you know? I'm really, really impressed by this castle thing over here. So we get like the farmers. Later on we could actually try to improve the farmers. Too bad that the small workshops does not change when you upgrade the keep. There'll be like actually something cool to see. Once you like get a bigger level of the castle than the workshop as well, like gives improved. So for example, you could try to queue up more tools, because right now if I want to make like a bow, then I have to like ride to this thing, hold the button and now I'm blocked. I cannot craft anything else. I have to wait for him to finish actually the tool that I've ordered him to build. So that's like a thing. But I really enjoy the how the fortifications look like, though. This thing over here, like, this could actually be like better. Like, without making it out of wood, I think it would be better if this thing would be made out of, like, proper stone, whatever. Oh! That's interesting. So, the bunker actually makes you 2 coins per day. Okay. That's actually good to know. Like, I like that the game actually shows you descriptions. Like, you don't have to go to the forum. You don't have to wait, like, till somebody finds out this thing. Like, this takes out the element of, like, exploring the game itself. But also allows you to plan ahead, I think, better. Like, you know exactly what certain things will happen, what certain structures will give you. So it's like, you know, one way or another, it's good or worse for some people. Like, depending how you're gonna look at that thing. Give the money to the banker. Okay, so he's gonna make almost 3 coins per day from now on because of the gold that I have deposited to him. So that's nice. We now have to just kill 11 more animals. Which is gonna probably happen after the after this night. Okay, the farmers are dropping me some coins, which is lovely. Hell yeah, baby! I like that the map is technically 3D, even though that they're gonna attack me only from 2 sides. It's like, but also I would love to have like more structures here, just so that the space would not look so empty. Just saying. But all in all, enjoying really a lot this game so far. I've ordered them to build like a wall over here, but I think this is like a bad idea. This guy takes way too much time to get to this position to build a wall. This is gonna be a downfall. No, cancel this thing. Cancel. Cancel. How do I cancel? I need to cancel. No, don't build the wall over here. This is a bad idea. Nope, nope. You're too slow. You should have built this thing in the morning, not now. Okay, let's actually test the destruction thingy. Destroy it. Come on, faster. Woo! Okay. Now run! Run to the hills! We just have to kill one more animal and we're done with this mission. Run faster! You idiot! Run! Fly, you fools! Fly! Come on, just kill one more animal, man. Ugh, it's not gonna work. I think I actually have to make like a wall closer and then try to expand towards that thing. Like the builders here, they have time, you know. They are not in a hurry. That's for sure. Like, oh yeah, sure. Why we should be in a hurry? An orcish horde knocking on the gates? Nah, that's not important, man. What's important is to chill. That's what's important. So chill, dude. We got this. Yeah. And then they wake up dead. That's exactly how this thing is gonna end. So I'm gonna get more archers, just in case. Come on, boys. Get to work. I have a thing or two for you to do. Most of you are gonna be shooting anyway, but still, you get the idea. Come on, more balls. And one more. There you go. Beautiful. Okay, let's see. Does the farmers have anything for me? You do! Sweet. Thank you. Much appreciated. Oh, wait. One more farmer. And I'm gonna try to clear out the forest. But probably I won't be able to because we just have to kill like the final animal. And the mission will end. And the final animal is dead. Victory! The King of Kings once again brings victory to the kingdom with his loyal subjects. And so the King of Kings decides to remain on this island to fortify his position as the one true leader. Aye. Okay, so this has been Island 2. As I said, this game is still like work in progress. So I'm not exactly sure how many more episodes I'm gonna record of this game. Just because I don't want to later on, you know, record the same things. Just in case the developers would decide the way you win the islands. Stuff like that. So, as I said, the knights are still like not in the game. So you can't technically attack a portal yet. You will be able to do that thing in the future, of course. But at the moment, that is not even a possibility. You just can't. You don't have an option to do so. So maybe we can actually like wait for the game to get like closer to this actual like release. If you want to try it yourself, I'll leave you as always link in the description below where you can get the game on Steam as scores. Anything else? No, my archers were just performing a moonwalk over there, so that's nice. So yeah, I think I'm gonna leave this thing as over here because I'm already roaming too much. So thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed the episode. Please subscribe a lot. Happy see you all in the next video.